February 23 is Sunday, 7th Sunday in Ordinary Time. Our reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Jesus said to his disciples, "You have heard that it was said, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. But I say to you, offer no resistance to one who is evil. When someone strikes you on your right cheek, turn the other one to him as well. If anyone wants to go to law with you over your tunic, hand him your cloak as well. Should anyone press you into service for 1 mile, go with him for 2 miles. Give to the one who asks of you, and do not turn your back on one who wants to borrow. You have heard that it was said, 'You shall love your neighbor and hate your enemy.' But I say to you, love your enemies and pray for those who persecute you, that you may be children of your heavenly Father, for he makes his sun rise on the bad and the good, and causes rain to fall on the just and the unjust. For if you love those who love you, what recompense will you have? Do not the tax collectors do the same? And if you greet your brothers only, what is unusual about that? Do not the pagans do the same? So be perfect, just as your heavenly Father is perfect." The Gospel of the Lord. The Way of Love. There is a joke among Filipinos that when someone throws stone at you, out of obedience to the biblical command, you should throw bread at him in return, along with the garapon or glass container. In the Sermon on the Mount, in the section about great holiness, Jesus commanded his disciples to go beyond the Torah of Moses, that among others order, an eye for an eye and a tooth for a tooth. This specifies that one's limb lost to be compensated by the offender's limb, a life for another life. This is popularly called lex talionis, which is the law of such or equivalent. A damage requires only an equivalent damage as payment. Though it may seem to us too cruel, it has in fact a benevolent purpose. It curtails the impulse for vengeance and unnecessarily bloodshed. For it is not a rarity in biblical times that when a person kills another person, his whole family will be killed in retaliation. This rage could be traced from the beginning of human relationships, as we see in the cry of Lamech. "I have killed a man for wounding me, a young man for bruising me." If Cain is avenged 7 times, then Lamech 77 times. Jesus goes beyond the lex talionis. Not only should the harm not be returned, but the person should even do good to his enemies. Jesus is here setting a new pattern of life. Just as his Father pardons and continues to shower the people with his blessing despite their betrayal, so must they do their enemies. Jesus himself set as example. When already dying on the cross, he asked his Father to forgive his killers. They know not what they do. Jesus' words are difficult to accept in a society where revenge and violence are felt almost everywhere. Does the love of enemies mean passivity, so that the Christian does not do anything to curtail the injustices going on around? This is not what Jesus means. In fact, he is teaching his followers to actively resist their enemies. The better move is to conquer the hearts of one's enemies. Then they are eliminated because they have ceased to be enemies. they have become friends.